This is the day that the Lord has made. We rejoice and we're glad in it. Somebody hold on. Don't let go. Man, this is my jam. One of them. Oh, I got a lot of songs. But this one, God have mercy. Lord, I just thank God that we can hold on and not let go. Keep on praying and don't you ever give up. Before we go, my God, further in the worship, can we just give God praise? And somebody tweet this. Somebody post this. Somebody tell somebody, hold on. Don't let go. Keep on praying. And don't you ever give up. Come on. Hold on. Don't let go. Keep on praying. And don't you ever give up. Why? Because he'll make it all right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God have mercy. God have mercy. Good morning, everybody. And know that this is the day that the Lord has made. We do rejoice and we're glad in it. We praise God for it. We bless God for it. I'm trying to let it go. I'm trying to let it go. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Can we give God praise because he is so faithful, so awesome, and so wonderful? I'm really trying. I'm really oh God, I'm really trying to let this go. Father, thank you that this is a day that you have made. We do rejoice and we're glad in it. We're grateful for it. We thank you for life, health, and strength, the activity of our limbs, food, shelter, clothing, the mind, the will, the power, and the desire to serve you. Lord, we truly declare there is none like you. None like you, and we give you glory. Now, Lord, you are the God we worship. You are the God we exalt, and you are the God we praise. Lord, take full charge of this time of worship, and let every enemy be scattered as you arise. Lord, we lift you up, and you draw men to you. We bless you, we honor you, we adore you, and we praise you, and thank you for this day. In Jesus' name. My God, beloved, Pastor Alice, get ready to come and lead us into worship. My God, I want y'all to worship together. Don't just watch her worship. Don't just sit there and say, oh, how wonderful that is. I don't care if you got rollers in your hair. We can't see you. But you can see us and you can join with us in lifting up your hands and worshiping God. My God, you can join us as she's coming now. Let's give God glory. Let's give God honor. Let's give God some great praise. He alone is worthy of it. He alone is deserving of it. He alone is great and awesome and mighty to save. Baby, you look good this morning.
Oh, thank you.
Orange is one of my favorite colors. Come on, sing us in the presence of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
This is the day the Lord has made, and we rejoice in it. We magnify the name of the Lord. We glorify his name. He alone is awesome. He is glorious. How many of you know that we are friends of God? Hallelujah. We're friends of God. Just like Abraham counted himself as a friend of God. And we thank God for that. We give God the glory, the honor, and the praise. Hallelujah. We magnify his name. Oh God, he is worthy of the praise. He's worthy of the glory and the honor and the adoration. We lift him up right now. We glorify you. We magnify you. Oh God, we worship you. We give you praise. We're friends of the Most High God. So therefore, we have relationship, right? We have relationship. We're happy. We're happy about that, that we have relationship with the Lord because we're friends, joint heirs with him. Oh, we worship you today, God. We give you glory, yeah. We give you praise. We give you the honor. Oh, in my day, you are mindful of me, that you hear me when I call. And is it true that you are thinking of me? How you love me? It's amazing. I am a friend of God. Yes, I'm a friend of God. My very best friend, yeah. I am a friend of God, yeah. I'm a friend of God. He's my friend, my closest friend, yes, he is. I raise my hands to you, Lord. Who am I that you? Yes, you're thinking of me. How you love me when I call. And is it true that you are? Is it true? Is it true, Lord? Yes, it is. That you love me. It's amazing. It's amazing. Yes, it is. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. Yes, I am a friend of God. Yes, I am. He called me friend. I am a friend of God. Yeah, I thank you, Jesus. I raise my hands. I give you all the glory. Yeah, you call me God Almighty, Lord of glory, you have only friend, God Almighty, you're the Lord of glory, yeah, you have called me friend. Thank you, Lord, I give you glory. I give you honor, I give you praise, God Almighty, you're the Lord of glory. I worship you, I bow down, and I give you glory, and the honor, and the praise, yeah, God Almighty, yeah. I raise my hands to you, and I lift you up in worship and adoration. Give you praise. Yes, yes, God Almighty. He's God Almighty. No other power, no other strength, no other source. He alone is worthy of the glory. I am a friend of God. Yeah, I am a friend. talks with me and he tells me I'm his own. Yeah, yeah. And the joy we share, yeah. As we tell me that not other, not other has ever known, yeah. Yes, yes, I am a friend of God. I thank you, Lord, for this relationship. I thank you, God, because I love you. I know you love me, Lord. Yes, he does. He calls you friend. Yeah. You can depend on him. He calls me friend. I worship you. I glorify you. I give you glory. Yeah. I give you the honor. I give you the praise. I magnify you. I give you praise. Yeah. I give you glory. I worship you. I give you the adoration. I adore you. I adore you. Come on and worship him with me. Come on. Worship him. Worship him. Yes, you deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve the glory. You deserve my worship. You deserve my praise. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Come on and raise your hands right now with me. Yeah. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. I worship you, God, because you deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. I bless you. You deserve it. My hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on and sing it. Come on. My hallelujah. My hallelujah. Nobody else but you. Nobody else but you. My hallelujah. Oh, I bless you. I praise you. Come on and wave your hand before him right now. My hallelujah. You deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. You deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. Yeah. All of the glory. Yes, come on. Give it to him. We give you the glory. We give you all the praise, Jacob. All of the glory belongs to you. All of the glory belongs to you, Jesus. We worship you in spirit and in truth. All of the glory. You deserve it, yeah, yeah. You deserve it, you deserve it, yeah. Here it is, here it is, here it is. We give it to you, we give it to you, we give it to you, Jesus. Yes, and hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, we give you the glory. All the honor and all the praise, yeah. You deserve it, yeah. You, nobody but you deserve it, yeah. Nobody but you deserve the glory. Nobody but you is gonna get the praise today. Nobody but you, nobody but you. You deserve it, you deserve it, yeah. Lord, I love you, I praise you. I praise your name today, you deserve it, yeah. You deserve it, you deserve it. Come on, let's give it to him. Come on, let's sing it again. Come on, say hallelujah. 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 Lord, we give you glory. All the honor. Come on, and all the praise, yeah. You. day, you deserve it, yeah. You deserve it, yeah. My hallelujah belongs to you. Come on and sing it with me today, yeah. My hallelujah belongs to you. Come on, lift your hands and say, my hallelujah belongs to you. Yeah, my hallelujah belongs to you. Come on and wave your hand right now.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, 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 oh. Somebody just worship him. Pastor Al just brought us in the presence of the Lord. Somebody don't miss this moment. I feel Jesus in this place. Come on, bless him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Come on, lift those hands and worship. Lift those hands and worship. Lift your voice and worship. God is worthy. God is worthy. God is worthy of the glory, worthy of the honor, and worthy of the praise. Can somebody just declare, he deserves it? He deserves it. He deserves it. Hallelujah. And Lord, we give you glory. We give you great praise, great honor. Lord, you deserve the adoration. You deserve the glory and the glory and the glory over and over again. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm so thankful for Pastor Al. I'm so thankful for the presence of God. My God, everybody, y'all ready for the word? Come on, hold up your Bibles and let's declare together. Lord, I thank you that I have the Bible. It is my personal copy, a basic instruction before leaving earth. I am a believer, not a doubter. I'm not just a hearer, but I'm also a doer. And my life is so much better because of the word of the living God. Therefore, I declare my mind is alert. My heart, it is receptive. And I will not be distracted, but I will hear exactly what God has for me. And as a result of what I hear today, I'm going to leave this experience greater than I came here. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. God is so faithful. Oh my God, beloved, I feel Jesus in this place. Today I want to talk from the topic, Keys to Effective Mind Renewal. We're still preaching, teaching, ministering on this theme of living post-pandemic, preparation for the new normal. This is a topic of the series, preparation for the new normal, because I'm sure you know by now, we're not going back to the way things used to be. I don't want to go back to the way things used to be. If God wanted me back there, then this pandemic wouldn't be used as a point of change. We are transferring our energy from the church age to the kingdom age. And we're moving in that steadily to come into God's presence and take back ground that the enemy has stolen, ground that we've abdicated, ground that we've left. And we're going to get it in Jesus' name. So keys to effective mind renewal, because you're not going to be able to get this ground back. In fact, get these mountains back without mind renewal. So beloved, before we proceed, I want you to understand that this is not a message that is focused on psychological theories. Because sometimes when you start talking about the mind, folks start getting these thoughts that somehow this is going to be something about, you know, mind things and psychobabble and all that. No, no, no. My God, my intent today, led by God, is to bring us all to the place of supernatural mind washing. Not brainwashing as we thought, but supernatural mind washing. My God. So can we get into this word? Because I want to explain it the best way I can. In fact, better than what I can do, let's read the words of Jesus. Look at Luke's Gospel, chapter 5, verse 36 to 38. Luke's Gospel, chapter 5, verse 36 to 38. You there yet? Come on. And he spake unto them, Luke 5, 36, also a parable. No man putteth a piece of new garment upon an old. If otherwise, then both the new maketh a rent, and that piece that was taken out of the new agreeth not with the old. Come on, the words of Jesus. And no man putteth new wine into old bottles. God have mercy. Else the new wine will burst the bottles and be spilled, and the bottles shall perish. But new wine must be put into new bottles. Hear the key. And both are preserved. And both are preserved. Somebody say, I'm being preserved. Oh yeah, I'm being preserved. I again do not undervalue the lives of those who have gone on before us. As I've often told you, this time last year, my father was about to transition. So we're coming up on a year of him being absent from the body, present with the Lord. I feel the missing of his presence. I dare not undervalue anybody's sense of missing a relative, a family member, or a loved one. But I must sober us with this word. Hear me. God has preserved us for a reason. God is preserving us for a reason. Some of us may want to stay back in the church age. Some of us may want to stay back in the way things used to be. But I hear God preserving us for a reason. Why? Number one, we got some mountains to take back. And preservation is the key for all of us. The fact is, can I speak to you plainly? You cannot be preserved in and with a stale mindset. Oh, I'm coming down that street today. You cannot be preserved with a stale mindset. What's a stale mindset, Bishop? Stale mindset, manifestation number one, is a drama monger. You love drama, love to keep stuff going. Number two, manifestation is perpetual paranoia. Everybody gonna get me. Everybody out to get me. Nobody likes me. Nobody gonna leave me alone. There's another mindset. Number three, racism. Man, that's so stale. Oh my God, we in the middle of a pandemic and folk are shooting folk, thinking they are a robbery suspect or a burglar, and they just out taking a jog. Folk are still murdering in Baltimore City, shooting each other like dogs in the street. Racism. Then there's classism. Help us, Lord. I'm better than you because I got one more bag of spaghetti. I'm better than you because I grabbed the last pack of toilet paper. The devil is a liar. Come on, saints. There is also comparison. Stale mindset. How do I match up against you? How do I stack up against you? Then there's a stale mindset of fear of progress. Fear of progress. You bet not, let me just go straight. You bet not in these days of transition from church age to kingdom age have a fear of progress. Progress is what God is calling for, because you can't put new wine in old bottles. Come on. Then there's a stale mindset of debilitation by failure. Listen, all of us have failed. If I could raise my feet, I will. All of us have failed. We failed in things in life, failed in pursuits, failed in going after things that we really wanted. But if failure was able to destroy you, it would have by now. Come on, somebody. If failure was able to destroy you, it would have by now. Mind renewal, hear me, requires change. Mind renewal requires change. Let me talk to you for a few more minutes. And I know that change is not easy. Change is not easy. In fact, change is one of life's, if not the most challenging entity there is. Change. But mind renewal is the working of the process to bring lasting, powerful, mountain-possessing change. Let me say it again. Mind renewal is the working of the process to bring lasting, powerful, mountain-possessing change. Now, before we close today, I want to talk about mind renewal from two aspects. Two aspects today we're going to get into. First of all, mind renewal from the aspect of how we think. And then number two, mind renewal from the aspect of what we do. How we think and what we do. Because this pandemic's going to come to a close. What side of change are you going to be on? What side of mountain taking are you going to be on? Are you going to be a taker or are you going to be a lacker? So I need you to understand change, mind renewal, from two aspects: how we think and what we do. So number one, let's walk through this. We must change how we think. Oh God. In changing how we think, we first of all got to be honest about how we think. You have to be willing to compare your mindset to the mindset of Christ. That is the only thing. You don't compare how you think with the brother down the street. You don't compare how you think with the sister next door. That is not what you do. Because the mind of flesh, the life of flesh, comparing to the flesh will fail you. The arm of flesh will fail you. So we compare ourselves to Christ. He is the prototype. He is the second Adam. He is the one that not only wants us to compare to him, but he empowers us to be like him. Man, I feel like preaching now, but I'm going to calm down for a moment here. Can't make no promises, my God, after this. But I want to declare the word of God. Now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know when he shall appear, we shall be like him, my God, for we shall see him as he is. And everyone who has an hope in himself purifies himself even as he is pure. God, through Jesus Christ, is our comparison. So let's look at this scripture from the Message Bible. I want to read it briskly. Philippians chapter 2, verse 5 through 16. I want to read it briskly because it is from the Message. A little more wordy, but powerful and substantive. Hear what the word of God says from the Apostle Paul in Philippians 2, 5 through 16 from the Message. Think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. He had equal status with God, but didn't think so much of himself that he had to cling to the advantages of that status no matter what. Not at all. When the time came, he set aside the privileges of deity and took on the status of a slave, became human. Having become human, he stayed human. It was an incredibly humbling process. He didn't claim special privileges. Are y'all hearing this? Instead, he lived a senseless, obedient life and then died a selfless, obedient death. Y'all, come on. Come on. Begin to understand. And the worst kind of death, that death called crucifixion. that death called crucifixion. How, God, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Oh, my God. Because of that obedience, God lifted him up. Pastor Al, you got to know what the Lord says. She over there rejoicing. You got to know, hallelujah, that God lifted him up high and honored him far above and beyond everyone and anything ever, so that all created beings in heaven and on earth, even those long ago dead and buried, will bow in worship before this Jesus Christ and call out in praise that he is the master of all. Hallelujah. He is the master of all, to the glorious honor of God the Father. What I'm getting at, friends, is that you should simply keep on doing what you've done from the beginning. Hear what the man of God said from the Message. When I was living among you, you lived in response of obedience. Now that I'm separated from you, keep it up. Better yet, redouble your efforts. Be energetic in your life of salvation, reverent and sensitive before God. That energy is from God. That energy is from God's energy. An energy deep within you. God himself, willing and working at what will give him the most pleasure. Do everything readily, God have mercy, and cheerfully. No bickering, no second guessing allowed. God, oh God, go out into the world uncorrupted, a breath of fresh air. Lord have mercy, in this squalid and polluted society, provide people with a glimpse of good living and the living for God. Carry the light-giving message into the night, so I'll have good cause to be proud of you on the day that Christ returns. Hear this last sentence. You'll be living proof that I didn't go to all this work for nothing. Oh my God. I know that was a mouthful from the Message Bible, but let's break it down. What is the mindset of Christ from this text? First of all, the characteristic of meekness. The mindset of Christ. Meekness is not weakness. Meekness is defined as strength under control. The second characteristic is confidence. Confidence in God's power above all else. Confidence in God's power above all else. Third characteristic is humility or submission. Coming under in order for the greater to rise. Humility, submission. Then there's a characteristic of selflessness. Oh God, the mind of Christ. Selflessness. Then there's a characteristic of obedience. Doing what God tells you to do, quite simply, without compromise. Then there's a characteristic of expectation in and of God. I'm not looking to myself for results. I'm looking to him to work in me, to will and to do of his good pleasure. Oh God, my expectation is in God. Characteristic next is deflecting self and reflecting Christ. Deflecting self and reflecting Christ. Let me say those again real quick. Meekness, mindset of Christ. Confident in God's power above all else. Mindset of Christ. Humility and submission. Mindset of Christ. Selflessness, mindset of Christ. Obedience. The Bible says he was obedient even to death. The death of the cross. God have mercy. Next characteristic, expectation in God alone, not in any other. Next characteristic, deflecting self, reflecting Christ. It's like a mirror. I saw on TV the other day, there's a new exercise apparatus that's called the mirror. Somebody is exercising, showing you how to do it. Man, what an invention that is. Somebody, as that mirror is on the wall, is talking to you, showing you how to do the exercises, man, they're going to be a millionaire if they're not already. Because that is the way to do it. Don't just tell me, show me. Jesus shows us what that mindset of renewal looks like. He is calling us, and the Apostle Paul, he spoke it. Let this mind be in you. We ought to be mountain takers. We got to have our minds renewed by the power and the example of God. That's what we're talking about today. That's how we're going to have our minds renewed. Changing according to the example lived before us. And not only that, can I say one more thing? Not only live before us, but live from within us. Christ in me. Oh, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. Christ in me, working the will and the do of his good pleasure. Oh, I love the way the man of God puts it. We are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works. Aren't you glad you don't have to do it by yourself? Aren't you glad you don't have to struggle with this? But let this mind, oh God, take the brakes off. Take off the barriers. Take off the interference. Take off the inhibitions. Let this mind be in you. Oh, Jesus. So mind renewal. Mind renewal. Man, you better. Oh, Lord have mercy. How we think. Let this mind be in you. But the second aspect is, what do we do? Lord, help me finish this. I feel the Holy Ghost. What do we do? Look with me and how this is fleshed out in Joshua chapter 14, verse 6 to 8 first. Joshua 14, 6 to 8. Go look at Brother Caleb. Here this 85-year-old man went through the times of slavery in Egypt, saw the death angel come and deliver the people of God, went through the 11-day journey before they got to Canaan. But unfortunately, when he and the other 11 spies came back, him and Joshua had a good report, but 10 others turned the hearts of the people and caused it to melt. As a result, what would have been an 11-day journey turned into 40 years of wandering. But guess what? Caleb survived them 40 years when the others died. Oh, God. Now, 85 years old, crossed the Jordan River, crossed over into the Promised Land, crossed over with Joshua, and helped everybody else get their possession. Now, he didn't limp up to Joshua. He walked up with a straight back, 85 years old, walked up with a mind to possess and a mind to take what's his, and said the following words in Joshua 14. Man, I feel this. Chapter 14, verse 6 to 8. Then the children of Judah, oh my God, notice the tribe Caleb came from, came unto Joshua in Gilgal. Judah is my lawgiver. Kings came out of Judah. Possessors came out of Judah. I'm from the tribe of Judah because I'm a praiser. Judah means praise. Here comes this praiser up to Joshua saying, look at here. Caleb the son of Jephunneh, the Kenizzite, said unto him, thou knowest the thing that the Lord said unto Moses, the man of God. Moses didn't even make it over to the Promised Land. My God, concerning me and thee in Kadesh Barnea, 40 years old when I was with Moses, when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land. And I brought him word again, as it was in my heart. Nevertheless, my brethren that went up with me made the heart of the people melt. But I wholly followed the Lord. God have mercy, my God. And now, behold, the Lord has kept me alive. Can somebody just pause and praise God right there? And now the Lord has kept me alive. Oh, God have mercy. Ah, as he said, these 40 and 5 years, even since the Lord spake this word unto Moses, while the children of Israel wandered in the wilderness, and now, lo, I am this day 85 years old. 85, a score is 20 years. Joshua and Caleb was around the same age, 85 years old. As yet I am as strong this day as I was in the day that Moses sent me, and my strength as it was then, so even so is my strength now for war, to both go out and to come in. God help me. Skip down to verse 10 out of chapter 14. Now therefore, Caleb said, give me this mountain, whereof the Lord spake unto me in that day. For thou heardest in that day how the Anakim were there, and that the cities were great and fenced. If so be the Lord will be with me, then I shall be able to drive them out, as the Lord said. The Anakim were giants, and they were giants tall and big in stature and big in renown. My God, by the time Caleb started fighting and taking over the land, Caleb himself went to possess the throne of Anakim, not just the land of his sons, but Caleb took Anakim's house. Caleb took Anakim's land. Oh, y'all got to study it out. Caleb was a bad dude at 85 years old. My God, he went and took what God had for him. Who am I preaching to today? Somebody got to know your time ain't done. Somebody got to know your life is not over. Somebody got to know that God is not done with you. Who is a seasoned saint that I'm preaching to right now? Who's in their 60s? Who's in their 70s? Who's in their 80s? Who declare that just as I had strength, then I have strength now to go in and out for war. Why are you talking about war, Bishop? Because the kingdom suffered violence, but the violent shall take it by force. As long as I suck wind, as long as I breathe breath, I'm going to conquest. I'm going to take back. I'm going to go after what God has for me. What are you going to do? God have mercy. God have mercy. What are you going to do? See, when you got mind renewal governs what you do. You just can't have a new mind and do nothing with it. Shame on you for asking God to renew your mind, but you don't reflect that mind renewal in what you do. The devil is a liar. I bind every work of darkness that continually tries to make you sit on your do nothing. I don't care how old you are. I don't care how much you failed in the past. Get up and do what God said. You still have mountains to take. You still have possessions to grab hold to. Can I get somebody to declare with me, it's time to do something? Mind renewal will get stale if you do nothing. What sense is getting your mind renewed? It's just like going to school, earning a degree, earning a doctorate in medicine, and never help nobody, never put it in practice. What good is it just to say, well, I'm a PhD, so can you help somebody? Oh, what did Caleb do? Number one, he was faithful to God. Oh, yeah. Number two, he was loyal to leadership. 40 years wandering will make somebody unloyal. Oh, age goes on and time goes by. When is God going to do what he said? He has a time set, and you'll be strong enough. Your children will get the benefit. Your children's children will get the benefit. But you got to be faithful to God and loyal to leadership. You got to have a mission mindset. I'm here to do what God told me to do. Oh, come on, somebody. Caleb, what did he do? He survived until he was able to thrive. Now, I don't like this point of view, but some people say fake it till you make it. Now, let me change it. Faith it till you make it. Don't fake it. I'm on my way somewhere. Oh, Jesus. I feel like dancing right now. Don't fake it. Faith it till you make it. Keep talking right. Keep thinking right. Keep moving in the direction God said. Don't fake it. Now, go ahead and make it. Caleb didn't just survive. He thrived. What else did Caleb do? Caleb wanted what God had for him. Some of you have said, it's been so long, I don't know if I still want it. It's taken too long to come. I don't know if it's for me. I declare God has a time set, and what God has for you is for you. And you'll live long enough. You'll be strong enough. You'll go up enough to take possession. Because God don't fail. Number one again, what the king, oh God, oh Jesus, oh my God, I'm trying to hold my mule here. I feel the Holy Ghost. God, have mercy. What did Caleb do? Caleb was faithful to God. Caleb was loyal to leadership. Caleb was mission-minded. Caleb survived until he thrived. Caleb wanted what God had for him. What you do reflects your mindset. Your mindset orders what you do. What you do reflects your mindset. And your mindset reflects what you do. To possess mountains, as I get ready to close, God have mercy. You must think what you do and do what you think. To possess mountains, you must think what you do and do what you think. A time ago, I made this declaration. Start declaring every day from the place of your imagination. Start speaking out of your mouth. See yourself seated at the top of your mountain. Oh, Lord, start declaring that I am going to possess what God has for me. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what the gainsayers have to say. I don't care what people think. I don't care how long it's been. You're looking at a man who has received several promises from God, and time has seemed to go by. And I know I've got plenty of doubters that said God left him. He's outlived his prime, and he will never get what God had for them. But let me serve notice on every doubter. I'm not just talking to people. I'm talking to the spirit of darkness that's trying to discourage not only me, but you. I'm still able to go out and come in. I'm still able to do what God would have me to do. Can I give you a secret? There has never been a time like this time where I'm riding a bicycle doing 7 miles in less than 20 minutes. Somehow, some way, God has given me strength. I'm still able to do what I got to do. Every other day, 150 push-ups. Oh, Lord, I thank God. I don't glory in my flesh, but he renews my strength. My mind goes over to Isaiah when it says, God have mercy, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and not faint. Who am I preaching to? God has given a second wind. God has given a third wind. God has given a fourth wind. When the enemy comes in to discourage, pick yourself up and say, give me my mountain. Not only am I still able, I have more wisdom than I did when I was younger. Can I throw this at you? You may not be honest, but I'll be honest for me. I didn't have the wisdom to possess what I'm getting ready to possess now. I needed more wisdom. I needed more understanding. Now with God's help, he's going to bring to pass quickly everything he said. As quickly as this thing came will be as quickly as it leaves. And beloved, those who stand are going to see the salvation of God. Anybody can say I'm too old, but somebody ought to say, give me my mountain. Because you have the mind of Christ. Let me close. Oh Lord, because you have the mind of Christ, you're going to think right. Yes, you are. Because you have the mind of Christ, you will do right. Yes, you will. Because you have the mind of Christ, you will be right. Yes, you will. Because you have the mind of Christ, you gonna make it right. Oh Lord, because you have the mind of Christ, you will possess right. Don't have to worry about is pride gonna set in. I've been through too much to get too proud now. I've been through too much to let stupidity hinder me now. Who feels like you're wiser? Who feels like you're stronger? Who feels like you're more empowered to do what God would have you to do? It's not just a mindset. It's also what I do. Oh God, can I preach this thing? So you got to renew your mind, because it's time to possess the mountains. The mountain of government. The mountain of arts and entertainment. The mountain of business and industry. The mountain of education. The mountain of family. Oh God. The mountain of media. And the mountain of religion. Not religion the way we thought, but true and pure religion and undefiled. Taking care of the widow, feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, helping people that don't have no help. I decree and declare, God is strengthening you not to just survive. You're about to thrive. Your mindset is of a thriver. Your mindset is of somebody that's been planted in the house of God and will flourish in the courts of God. Who am I preaching to? I need you to say, I have the right mindset and I'm going to do something with it. My God, I got to go. But the story is told, oh Lord, of a man who had a clogged up sink. God have mercy. He had a clogged up sink and he went to the store to buy the unclogger solution. Ain't gonna get no props or somebody ain't gonna give me no check. So beloved, I just gonna say the unclogger solution. The man, he poured in the solution into the clogged up sink and waited 5 minutes and nothing happened. He got a little impatient. So he bailed out the sink and did it over again. Poured the solution, my God, into the sink and nothing happened. The man got angry and he called the manufacturer that was on the back of the package of the solution and said, I done bought 3 bottles of this stuff. I poured the whole bottle into the clog. And it did nothing. So I bailed it out. And then I took another bottle and poured it in. And it looked like it ain't doing nothing. He began to fuss at the person from customer service and talk about how bad their drain unstopper was. Oh Lord. And he began to fuss. And then when the customer service agent got a free moment to talk, he said, sir, can I make a suggestion? Pour the last bottle. Don't even use the whole bottle. Pour half the bottle in the sink and go make yourself a sandwich. He said, just walk away for a while and go make yourself a sandwich. And the person on the other end, in effort to calm down the consumer, said these words, let it do what it do. He said, let the solution do what it's made to do. So the man calmed down. He said to the person, all right, I'm going to let it do what it do. But if it don't do what it's supposed to do, I'm calling the president and I'm going to have your job. So the man, he went into the kitchen after pouring half a bottle solution and made not only one sandwich, but made two sandwiches. He sat down and enjoyed a little bit of the sports channel on television. Oh, Lord. And about 30 or 40 minutes later, he came back and the clog was gone. He came back and the sink, my God, was no longer clogged up. He ran some water into the sink and the sink water went down very fast like it used to. Oh Lord, why did it work? Because he let the solution do what it do. Who am I preaching to? Somebody out there listening to me, you got to let the Holy Ghost do what he do. When the Apostle Paul was talking to us in Philippians, he said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. When you let something, you don't put cuffs on it. When you let something, you don't put inhibitions on it. When you let something, you let it do what it do. By God, I feel a dance coming on. I got to get up out of here. Oh, God have mercy. Somebody today, tweet that, talk that, and say, let it do what it do. Jesus, let God work in you. Let your mind be renewed by the power of the Holy Ghost. Let him work in you to will and do of his good pleasure. Because when he's done, it will be done. Come on, somebody, praise God. Oh, praise him. Lord, have mercy. I done preached myself happy. Excuse me for a minute. Hey, glory, hallelujah. I feel the Lord up in this place. Let it do what it do. Let him do what it do. Because you got some mountains to take. You got some ground to cover. Hey, Jesus. Whoa, God, I feel this up in here. Lord, have mercy. It's time to let God arise and every enemy be scattered. Let God do what he do. Let God do what he do. Let God do what he do. The first thing he do, he came to seek and save the lost. He came to save you from your sin, to baptize you in the Holy Ghost, and to give you brand new life. He came to save you. Self-effort ain't going to save you. Buying the gimmicks ain't going to save you. The precious, efficacious, effective, powerful blood of Jesus was shed to save you. I love this name of Jesus. He's described as the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. He is the Lamb of God. John called him out. Who takes away the sin of the world? Eradicates it. Solves the problem. Makes you new. Let him do what he do. From the guttermost to the uttermost, Jesus alone saves. The Bible says, he that calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. I need you today, if you're not saved, to call on Jesus. Somebody once said, you call on him, he'll answer prayer. Can I get a witness? Somebody today needs to give their heart to Jesus. Today. 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 Also, if you backslid and walked away from God, he's right where you left him. Come on back where you dropped him off. He's still there with arms stretched out, waiting for your return. Let him do what he do. He is a great redeemer. I will sing of my redeemer. With his blood he purchased me. On the cruel cross he pardoned, paid my debt, and set me free, made me free, keeps me free. Right now, there are prayer warriors stationed on all of our media outlets. They see your name. They see your prayer requests. We're praying for you right now. If you need prayer in something generic, if you want to be saved, write it out. Somebody going to see it. We're going to begin praying for you. If you need to contact us and talk to us, right now, call 443-776-0255. Somebody's waiting to return your call and pray for you. Also, if you need prayer, you can email us at lbcministry@yahoo.com. lbcministry@yahoo.com. Beloved, I know Jesus saves. I know he heals. He delivers. I know he wants to make you who you're supposed to be. He is the burden bearer, the heart fixer, the heavy load sharer. And if you're here today, you got to fall in love with him and let him do what he do. Right now, Sean Pace Rhodes, we don't own this music. We don't own the rights to it. We bought the music. But I want you to know everything performed, we don't own the rights, but we use it for ministry. I want you to know this song means so much. You got to fall in love with the doer, the mind fixer, the heart regulator, the one that empowers you. His name is Jesus. God bless you. Last but not least, well, two more things. This is the first Sunday I'm going to do this. If you do not have a church home and want to be a part of Life Builders Church, you can become a part today cyberly. You may live in Michigan. You may live in Nova Scotia. Yeah, we would love for you to find a good church where you live. But until you do, we receive you as a partner in Life Builders Church. Make that known. Make that known. I consider myself a partner of Life Builders Church. Because partnership has privileges. You can make it known by calling 443-776-0255 or writing us by email at lbcministry@yahoo.com. Partnership has privileges. Last but not least, I gotta go. If you desire, as you desire to give, look at here. Beloved, I've always said you can't receive anything when you refuse to give anything. But I want you to understand, you're giving to come out on the other side. This ain't no gimmick. This is the truth. I'm coming out prosperous. I'm coming out blessed. I'm coming out better than I went in. Givers, tithers, in obedience to God, see the provision of God in a way they've never seen before. So if you desire to give, it's available to you now. We can mail it. You can mail it in. The address is going to be on your screen. Or you can use PayPal. Go on to PayPal, lbcministry@yahoo.com. lbcministry@yahoo.com. Put that email address in. Assign the amount you're going to give. it will get to us securely. God bless you. What a day. What a day. What a day. Can you worship God with us? God bless you. Father, cover your people with the blood of Jesus. As quickly as this pandemic has come, it's about to leave as quickly. I know we've been saying that, but Lord, you're working a work. And I thank you for doing what you do. Now keep us by your spirit. Protect us by your power. May the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with all of us now, henceforth, and forevermore. And may the peace of God that passes all understanding keep our hearts and minds by Christ Jesus. This is our prayer. God bless you. Grace and peace be unto you, and peace be multiplied in Jesus' name. God bless. Have a great day. Come on, let's worship God. Hallelujah. How I love Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah. Whoa, glory.
Thank you. You trust me.